myself, Dr. Chaitanya Krishna, professor in the EC department. Here, I'm going to deal a topic is a coordinate system in the subject electromagnetic fields and waves. Here, why we can deal in this topic in that particular subject is a whatever the electromagnetic field components, whatever the electromagnetic field, we can analyze that electromagnetic field by using these coordinate systems. These three coordinate systems here, basically these three coordinate systems are the Cartesian coordinate system and cylindrical coordinate system and spherical coordinate system. Now, based upon these three only, we can analyze the electromagnetic fields where the signal strength in the Cartesian, cylindrical, spherical coordinate system. Now, the basic coordinate system is a Cartesian coordinate system. Here, the Cartesian coordinate system components coordinates are the x, y, z. And this Cartesian coordinate system we can also call as a rectangular coordinate system. Why we can call as a rectangular coordinate system? The shape of this coordinate system is a rectangular shape. Here, the Cartesian coordinate system Here the Cartesian coordinate system, x and y and z, if we can take the any point on the particular coordinate system that has the x component as well as y component as well as z component. Now, by using this Cartesian coordinate system, in the Cartesian coordinate system is a vector form is a bar equal to ax, ax bar plus ay, ay bar plus az, az. Now here, this means, here ax means unit vector in the x direction, unit vector in the y direction, and unit vector in the z direction, and the magnitude in the x direction, and magnitude in the y direction, and magnitude in the z direction. This is a representation of a vector in Cartesian coordinate system. Here, the Cartesian coordinate system coordinates are the x, y, z are there. The limits of this coordinates are the minus infinity to plus infinity for x and y and z. Minus infinity to plus infinity. This is about this Cartesian coordinate system. The next one is a cylindrical coordinate system. The cylindrical coordinate system, the coordinates are the rho comma phi comma z. Rho comma phi comma z. Now, here, the next one is a cylindrical coordinate system. The cylindrical coordinate system, it means the shape of the coordinate system is a cylindrical shape. If we can take any point on this cylindrical coordinate system, for example, we can take a P point that has a component of the rho and phi and z. Now, what is the rho component and what is the phi component and what is the z component? Here, the rho component is a radius from the z axis to whatever the points we can take on the surface of the cylinder. The radius is we can call as a rho. The next one is the what is the phi means? Phi is the azimuthal angle on xy plane. Azimuthal angle on xy plane from x axis. Here the phi is the azimuthal angle on xy plane from x axis, and z is the same as the Cartesian coordinate system, z direction component. This is the cylindrical coordinate system components, and limits of the cylindrical coordinate system components are the rho limits, the radius from the z axis to surface of the cylindrical, we can have the limits from 0 to infinity, and azimuthal angle limits from 0 to 2 pi, and z axis limits is the z component limits is the 0 minus infinity to plus infinity. This is a cylindrical coordinate system component. The vector representation in the cylindrical coordinate system as the a bar is equal to a rho bar plus a phi bar plus a z. Here the rho direction, the magnitude is a rho, phi direction the magnitude is a phi, and z direction the magnitude is a z. Now the next coordinate system is a spherical coordinate system. The spherical coordinate system is a the next coordinate system, the spherical coordinate system. The spherical coordinate system coordinates are the r comma theta comma phi. The representation of this spherical coordinate system is this one. Here what is r value and what is the theta value and what is the phi value. Now r value is the radius of the sphere from r z, radius of the sphere means here whatever the point we can take on the surface of the sphere from the distance from the origin to that point, we can call it as r. Next one is the theta value. This is the angle from the z axis to whatever the point we can take on the surface of the sphere, that angle we can call it as the theta. And next value is the phi. Phi value is the same as the whatever we have discussed in the cylindrical coordinate system, that is the azimuthal angle on xy plane from the x axis. This is a spherical coordinate system. Here the spherical coordinate system coordinates limits are the r limits from 0 to infinity and theta limit 0 to 5 and phi limit 0 to 2. And a vector representation of this spherical coordinate system, a bar is equal to ar bar plus a theta bar plus a phi. Now based upon these three coordinate system components, now we can how to convert one coordinates into the another coordinates. Now we can see. Here, the first we can represent, we can take one coordinate system. For example, is a x component and y component and z component. Here we can take one point, here the p of x comma y comma z, that is equal to p of rho comma phi comma z, and that is equal to r comma theta comma. If we can take one point on any coordinate system that has the three coordinates x comma y comma z, the same as the rho comma phi comma z and r comma theta comma, we can take this point. Now based upon the definition of all these three, we can take and we can represent all these definition in this diagram. Now first one, we can represent the cylindrical coordinate system. What is the rho? Rho value from z axis to whatever the point is there, that radius is we can call as a rho. And on the xy plane, whatever the angle is there, that angle we can on the xy plane. From the x axis to that point, the angle is a phi, and next value is the z direction coordinates, the z component. Based upon this one, we can write as a x component and y component. Here this x and this is a y, from here to here and here to here. Means here the y means here also y, here also x. Now, spherical coordinate system components, according to the definition, from the origin to point, whatever the point we can take, that value is the r value, and from the z axis to the point, angle between these two, we can call as a theta. Now, in this one diagram, we have the all these three coordinate system coordinates, and these three coordinate system values, these three coordinate system values. Now we can convert one coordinate system into another coordinate system by using this diagram. Now we can convert the Cartesian coordinate system into cylindrical coordinate system, or cylindrical to Cartesian coordinate system. The first one, we can convert the Cartesian cylindrical coordinate system components into Cartesian coordinate system components. Now we can take here also rho. Now based upon this triangle, rho square equal to x square plus y square. Then rho equal to under root of x square plus y square according to Pythagoras. This is a rho value. Rho value is a cylindrical value in terms of Cartesian coordinate systems. Next, tan phi. Based upon this triangle only, what is the tan? Tan phi value is a y by x. Now, phi is equal to tan inverse of y by x. Tan inverse of y by x. And this is the phi is the cylindrical coordinate system component. Phi is a cylindrical coordinate system component in terms of y and x is the Cartesian coordinate system component. The next value is the z value is there. The same z value is there in the Cartesian and cylindrical coordinate system. Now, from Cartesian coordinate system, cylindrical coordinate system into Cartesian coordinate system. Now, Cartesian coordinate systems into cylindrical coordinate system, we can convert by using this diagram only. By using this triangle, we can convert from the cylindrical coordinate systems into Cartesian coordinate system. Now, see here, what is the sine phi from this diagram? From this diagram, sine phi is equal to y by rho. Now, y is equal to rho sine phi. Y is equal to rho sine. Same as the cos phi value, x by rho, x by rho. Now, x is equal to rho cos. Same as the z value is z. Here, this is the conversion from the Cartesian coordinates into cylindrical coordinates and cylindrical to Cartesian. Now, the next one, we can convert the spherical coordinates into cylindrical coordinates, or cylindrical coordinates into spherical coordinates by using this triangle. We can convert cylindrical coordinates into spherical, or spherical coordinates into cylindrical coordinates. From this one, what is the r value? According to Pythagoras, from this triangle, r square equal to rho square plus z square. Now r is equal to under root of rho square plus z square. Now the next one is a, what is a tan theta? Tan theta equal to rho by z. Theta equal to tan inverse of rho by z. Tan inverse of rho by z. Here theta and r are the spherical coordinate system component that will be represented in the cylindrical coordinate system component. The next value is the r comma theta comma phi. Phi value is the same as the cylindrical coordinate system, whatever we can take the value. The phi value is the same as the phi value. R we can write as the tan inverse of y by x also. Tan inverse of y by x or tan inverse of y by x. In the cylindrical coordinate system and cylindrical coordinate system and spherical coordinate system, phi value is the same. That's why we can write as a phi. Phi value is the same as a phi. Now, cylindrical coordinate system components and spherical coordinate system components are there. Based upon this one only, we can analyze the signals in the different various coordinate system, and phi value is phi. Next, now.